G'day folks, Rod from My Water Filter here today. And what we're gonna do is have a look at the annual service, the globe replacement on the UV guard whole house UV system that comes complete with the MWF 20 inch whole house rainwater filtration system, okay? So generally you'll turn it on, it's gonna just go. Obviously there's the controller, alarm and a light on there. If the light's lit, power's on, whatever's going on. But generally you just turn this on and it'll stay on 24/7 throughout the whole year. Unless you've got any power fluctuations or anything that's been messing things around. Hopefully, normally, you'll just turn this on. It's filtering and sterilizing the water flowing into your house and you're good to go. But once a year, you do need to take a look at this thing. It is important to you. It is important to the family's health, etc. And we don't want to be messing around with it all the time. So we want to have one good old go, get it right the first time. So we don't have to be messing around with it, okay? So I've turned the power off. She's cooled down. It's all good to go. No worries at all. So first thing I'm gonna do is just get the little Phillips screwdriver and I'm going to take the electrical attachment off the end and then we'll go from there, okay? Just three little screws. Like anything else, if you take care of them, they'll be good to go every time you come out to put them on, put them off, etc. So tiny little bit of oil on the thread, something like that. Keep them happy, stop the rust from the moisture in the air, etc. So that's those three there, okay? From there, we just gently pull that off. There's a rubber O-ring on there as well. Rubber washer, sorry. And here's our globe. Just gonna gently pull him off the end, all right? There's our electrical component. What I'd be doing here, pull this flat washer off. You can buy these if you need them, and it does make a seal on here. So if the price for a couple of bucks, whatever it is, for a little flat washer like that, make sure it's in good nick. If it's not, let's get another one. Make sure there's no dirt, cobwebs, anything in here. Give it a wipe, give it a blow out. Make sure she's nice and clean and looking good, all right? And if that's the case, we'll be good to go there. Okay, here's our globe. So we're gonna pull our globe out, just gently, gently. Everything's always gentle, everything's always slow when we're playing around with the UV components, all right? Not putting our hands on the globe or anything, but there it is, and we'll just sit that one off to the side for the moment as well, all right? Now, we'll undo the large nut on the end. Now, when we screw it out, it depends what you've got. But these UVs are beauties, right? Now there's a spring in the end of here. So when you're unscrewing this nut, when you get to the end of the thread, the spring's gonna wanna push it. So the thimble, it's coming out this end. So you've gotta be aware of that. You don't wanna get a sudden shock and drop it and crack it or anything like that. So steady, steady. We're supporting it. We're just making sure everybody's happy. I've got full control of this nut here. And I'll show you what I mean as we get to the end of the thread. And we're getting there now, okay? So it's just, I can feel that spring just gently pushing back and it's pushed it back to here, all right? I'm gonna take the nut off, all right? Once again, even with the nut, I'll blow it out, give it a brush, give it a wipe, whatever it needs, keep this baby nice and clean. No reason for it to be getting really horrible, okay? On the end here, I'll take this quartz out first, and once again, just very gently pull it out, very gently. Sometimes they're coming out and they just do lock on a little bit. So very gently just pulling it out, okay? This system's only got rainwater in and hardly been here for very long, okay? So as you can see, it's still pretty clean and looking good. So I'm just gonna wipe this today and this thimble can go back in. Let's suggest you've got really harsh bore water, high calcium, something like that. This glass could be baked with white on the outside. And if that's the case, you need to, instead of an annual inspection, you better start checking that thing every month to start with, okay? If you pull this globe out and it's absolutely coated in calcium, what that means is when the globe is inside of it, the water can't penetrate out through the glass, okay? This glass has got to be crystal clear. As cleaner you can get it, the better penetration of light you'll have through it. into the housing to kill all the bugs inside the water. So this is vitally important that this is clean, all right? So we're gonna use this one again. If it was really bad and you couldn't scrub it and clean it, I would be getting a new one, okay? Simple as that. If you can clean it and put it back, you're good to go. If it was dirty, like I was saying a minute ago, you need to inspect it more frequently than once a year, okay? So maybe if it's really dirty now after a year and it caught you out, put it back in, give it a check in a month's time and see what it's looking like. If it's still pretty good, wipe it off, put it back, check it in 3 months and try and work out at what interval you need to be checking it to keep it clean. So maybe just twice a year or something and you're good to go, okay? So that's that one there. Obviously there's an O-ring on the end here. Couple of bucks for an O-ring. I'd be replacing this O-ring every time I put the new globe in, or even when I service it every year. It's just a little O-ring. They do last, don't get me wrong. You might get away with a bit longer than that, but I only like messing around with it once a year, put it all back together, and we're done and we're good to go. Okay? So we've pulled it out. Everything's been functioning well. There's nothing to worry about. Controller's kept dry and we're good to go. All right? So I'll sit him down there. When we go to put him back in, we want these things to be squeaky clean. That's regardless whether we've got new ones or we're replacing the old thimble, okay? Obviously the globe has to be replaced every year because the globe's only good for 9,000 hours, which is turned on fully, not 24/7 for a full year. So now we'll get the thimble, and what we're gonna do with that thimble, I'm just gonna quickly put just a cheap plastic glove on. And that's to keep my hands off the thimble and the globe when we put them in new, because we just don't want oily hands putting oil marks or anything on those UVs. We try and keep them as crystal clean as we can so we get the ultimate performance out of all, okay? So simple glove, slip him on like so. Got a bit of methylated spirits here. And I'll simply be using that at the moment. Get a tissue, folks, all right? So just get a tissue, get hold of the thimble, get him there, and we're just giving it a good old wipe over, want it nice and clean, and just wipe it and clean it as long as it takes, all right? As soon as you get that baby there, and it's looking beautiful and clean like that, then we're good to go, all right? So I'm just gonna slide that straight back in. Once again, gentle, gentle, very steady, very steady. As that globe's going back in, I can hear it sliding along the bottom here. It's gonna keep going all the way in. Till we get here. I can feel it hitting the bottom of the spring. I'm gonna stop at that point of time. I'm gonna get my new O-ring, make sure there's a little bit of lubrication on it. And I'm gonna put the new O-ring on. Okay. Now I'm gonna lift him up and sit him up into our spring at the other end. Right, there she goes. As I pushed it in, it's pushed that rubber right up against the thread and we're looking good. I've already cleaned our holding nut on, holding that in there. There we go. Beautiful. And then we're doing this nut up as tight as we can by hand and locking him up. Locked up, he's good to go. Now, what I'm gonna do now, before I put any electrical components in, I'm gonna turn on the pump and I'm gonna pump it up to pressure and I'm gonna make sure it's good to go, all right? I'm not gonna say she'll be right and just put the lamp in there just on the off chance that there is some water leaking out of this thing. So I'm turning it on now, pump's on, check that it's up to pressure, turn a tap on and off a couple of times fast, whatever you like to do, and we got no leaks. She's sealed up, a success, we're good to go, all right? Stage next one, we'll get that globe, get some metho on our tissue. Give her a wipe down. Brand new, right? Brand new globe. Globe only lasts for 9,000 hours, so every year we're getting a brand new globe. So brand new. Nice and steady, nice and gentle. No reason for any issues, mistakes or anything with these. Should all go very, very easily. Okay. electrical components, plug him in. Just before I do, I'll show you, just make sure you got that washer on and it's in good condition, okay? It's got to be on before you plug the electrical lead into our UV lamp. She's on. Line up the holes. Okay, just gently sliding him in. Get one of those screws into the hole. As I said before, we want it nice and easy and screwing in and out very well. So a little bit of oil on these screws if we need, just to stop any muck getting in the hole, gathering dirt, dust or rust over time, whatever it might be. And just take your time putting them in, because you do want to nail it and get it into the thread properly the first time. We don't want to be cross-threading any of these threads. So just take your time so they're never ever cross-threaded. They're always right and good to go from the start. Sometimes you might have to take one in and out. You might have to loosen one off. But just do what you have to do so that they just all go in very, very easily, smoothly, and then they can be done up tight. You are going to have a good seal between this plastic electrical base plate and that black washer we just saw inside. There we go. Another important factor is get a screwdriver with a head that fits these little screws properly, okay? Don't come along and just screw them and just chop all the inside of the screw out, we'll have a mess. Okay, so that's us, it's all done. We'll just quickly plug him in. Power's on, we can see here. We've got our green light on, so it's good to go, no alarm, that's a success. Okay, so I hope that helps. If we can help in any way, yell out, give us a call. We'll be happy to help in any way we can. Thank you very much.